And welcome back to the Mike Pressler Show here at Blackie's Bulldog Tavern. And we're joined once again by head coach Mike Pressler. And coach, another tough week coming up. You got two games again. This time, though, it's in a span of 3 days as you're taking on Yale on Friday and then Wagner at home on Sunday. You add a 10-game winning streak to the mix, and it's also senior day on Sunday as well. What's the message going to be to the team this week in practice?
Well, these two games this weekend are very, very have different themes to them. Yale is one of the best coach teams, one of the most disciplined teams that we'll play the entire year. Basically the same team they had a year ago, minus the goalie. Andy Shea does a heck of a job with that group. Impressive defensively, got some stars at the offensive end, and they're going to give Kevin Massa everything he can handle with the faceoff X with two guys, 46 and number 28. So this is going to be a battle. It was a one-goal game in our place a year ago. We cut it to one with a minute to go and lost a faceoff, lost the game. 2 years ago, we went down there and probably had one of our best performances. The last of the high school trips.
Yep.
You know, down in the Haven, down and back, it's going to be a tough out.
Yeah, you mentioned it's another one of the high school trips, and it's this Friday at 7 o'clock in New Haven. It'll be your third straight road game. Now, the all-time series between you and Yale, 1-1. Again, you mentioned last year you lost by 1-9-8 at home. 2 years ago, though, you beat them at their place 9-7 for the first win over that program. Right now, Yale 6-4 overall, 3-2 in Ivy League play, but they're literally playing Stony Brook as we're taping this show right now, so it'll be interesting to see how that one plays out as well. They're preseason number 4 in the Ivy League, and after a 4-overtime win over Brown on Friday, that improved their win streak to 4 games. Did you get a chance to see any of that game at Brown, and what did you take away from watching them play?
Yeah, I was over there for a half and watched the game on tape and compare scores. We beat Brown by a goal, they beat Brown by a goal. This is going to be a great, great battle. It could be a single-digit game, maybe because of both defenses, I think. Face-off play, again, critical for both teams. Yeah. Goalie play, critical. But I really like our matchup in the goal. Mm-hmm. Jamison Love, they got a new starter back there, a young man that's getting better. But Jamison's been a proven commodity for us for 4 years now.
Yeah.
And then Wagner, Wagner on senior day. What do you have to say? The six terrific seniors. This group of seniors was the first group in the Division I model.
Right.
So the first, all six were recruited to play at the Division I level. Mm-hmm. It's a group I'm very fond of. And playing against a Wagner team that beat Sacred Heart
right.
to finally end a 26-game losing streak. So. No extra motivation for that one either.
Right. And now, looking at the Yale game again, last year, 9-8 loss, but you were tied 3-3 at the half. They kind of broke it open a little bit in the third quarter. They went up 6-4, and you never could cut it back to less than one for the rest of the game. What kind of lessons did you guys take away from that game and might be able to use this year?
I think in that game especially, we didn't do a very good job on offense, and I think Yale had a lot to do with that. We just didn't handle kind of their slide package as good as well as I thought we would. I think where we hurt them was kind of in transition there a little bit as we made that comeback down from 8-5. But a very similar type of game it's going to be. We have no expectations to think it's not going to be that. They're a hungry bunch. They're back in the Ivy League hunt. I think they might have qualified for the Ivy League tournament. I'm not sure, but they're right on the cusp.
They're right on the cusp, sure.
They got Stony Brook tonight, us on Friday. They have a much shorter week than we do, and I kind of like that in our favor. We played plenty of lacrosse. 13 games is a season, and we got 3 more to go.
Yeah, and now we look at this Yale team led by Matt Gibson, a senior tackman. First team All-Ivy a year ago, preseason All-American, the preseason Ivy League Player of the Year. As of today, 22 goals and 13 assists. He had 5 goals against Brown. How do you like your matchup against Matt Gibson?
We're not sure how we're going to play him yet. I have to watch some more tape, but Matt's as good an attackman as there is in the game. Great, great lefty, great change of direction, has a nose for the goal. But he's not alone either. They got number 6 in the midfield, who's a handful, a couple young attackmen. So they're a very, very well-balanced team offensively.
Yeah, the freshman over there, Conrad Oberbeck, 18 goals, 6 assists. And then Braden Mangan, sophomore attackman, 16 goals, 8 assists as well. And kind of the question mark, I guess, becomes Jack Meyer, the sophomore goalkeeper. He's had a little bit of a tough year, only a .459 save percentage, but he had 4 saves in the 4 overtimes against Brown, so coming off a pretty good performance there. Now we shift over towards the senior day game. Sunday at Bulldog Stadium, 1 o'clock. Is there anything that you and the coaching staff have to do a little bit differently to kind of compensate for maybe some extra emotion that could accompany a senior day game?
Not really. We're a mature bunch that way, and we respect Wagner in spite of what has happened over the last 26 games. We respect their coaching staff. My own Anthony Iannello is the assistant coach there, one of Matt's former teammates. The motivation of just playing in your final regular season game at home, sending out those six seniors on a very positive note is something we all want to do.
Yep. And now, all time, you guys are 3-0 against Wagner, and you've beaten them by an average of 19-6 in the three meetings. So this is a series that you guys have dominated. You haven't had very many close games. The scores have been 19-9, 17-6, and 20-2 overall since you started playing. Right now, they sit at 1-11, and as you mentioned, they just had a 26-game losing streak broken against a very good Sacred Heart team last weekend. They were preseason number 6 out of 6 in the NEC, but, you know, is there any kind of feeling that this could be some kind of trap game at all for you guys?
You know, not really, because it's senior day. I mean, this is not something, and Matt Larson will tell you, we're a humble bunch. I mean, we know who we are, we know who we're not, we don't look by anybody. We feel we can beat anybody, we feel we can be had by anybody. So Wagner's not going to sneak up on us only with one day preparation. I mean, well, we played a lot of lacrosse, and this time of year, I think the practice part of it is maybe overrated.
Yep.
It's being fresh, it's being prepared, it's being sharp mentally, and I'm counting on our guys. Whatever happens on Friday night, we'll be ready to go on Sunday.
Right. And now, last year was a 19-9 victory. Is there anything you could take out of a victory by 10 goals against them?
Not really. New coaching staff.
Yep.
And then we have arguably their best player, Cody Isdaner, transferred to our place. So, a whole new style of play. Matt Pasquet, a lot of respect for Matt, head coach, young head coach from Virginia, great pro for the teammate, actually, Brad Ross at the Boston Cannons, and then our own Anthony Iannello is a defensive coordinator. So whole new staff, new atmosphere, and going to be an exciting game.
Yeah, you mentioned Matt Pasquet in his first season. He graduated from UVA in 2006, finally picked up his first win this past week. Some of the key players we look at for this team, for Wagner, Colin O'Rourke, a junior midfielder, 20 goals and 4 assists. Then they have another 20-goal scorer, and Nick DePhillips, he's a junior midfielder, 21 goals and 2 assists. Have you been able to take a look at those guys on tape?
Not really, Mike, yet. We're still getting ready for Yale, more towards the end of the week.
Right.
You know, a difficult thing for us because we have to have two scouting reports ready by the weekend. So a huge turnaround, quick turnaround after Yale, and then get ready for Wagner.
Now, when you practice against, or you would practice for two teams in a such a short span, how do you guys compensate for that during the week of practice?
Well, we just everything's about Yale now,
and
we'll focus in on Wagner on Saturday. We'll watch Wagner film. We'll stay in our routine. We'll watch the Yale tape before Saturday's practice, then watch Wagner film and scouting report after, and tee it up on Sunday at 1 o'clock in Bulldog Stadium, on TV, I think, too.
Yep, we will have that on Cox Sports Television. It should be a very fun game to have. The weather could be a little iffy, so hopefully the rain stays away. But as we take a look at these two games individually again, first with Yale, what do you see as being the biggest factor, and then, of course, the X factor for pulling out a victory?
We got to play very disciplined on defense. You know, they're crafty enough and clever enough. If we have a blunder or two, they're going to take advantage of that. We got to get our more than our share at the face-off X like we've done all year. And Jameson's absolutely got to out-duel Myers that way. And then offensively, we just got to get our transition game going. And just, again, kind of get back to doing what we've been doing to be successful. But we're, we just got, again, I can't say it enough, a lot of respect for the Yale bunch, their coaching staff, and all the talent they have.
And now the same question for Wagner, possible X factor, is that still too far in the future to even figure out what that could be?
It's going to be about our energy, with a quick, 2-day turnaround, us being excited to play. And I think because it's senior day, that side of it will be on our side of the ledger, being, motivated to send out Matt Larson and the other five on a very, very positive note.
Well, Coach, we certainly hope you guys can pull out two more wins here. Again, they travel to Yale in New Haven this Friday, a 7 o'clock game underneath the lights, and then senior day at Bulldog Stadium, 1 o'clock this Sunday. We thank you again for watching the Mike Presser Show here on Cox Sports Television.